So okay guys, so let's continue with the double reinforced beam. So bali dito, meron tayong beam width na 410, then yung effective depth niya is 586 mm, no? So yan yung effective depth ng tension bars, then yung effective depth ng compression bars meron tayong 60 mm. So it is reinforced with tatlong tag 28 mm diameter bar tsaka tatlong tag 20 mm diameter bar. So given yung FCU prime na 20.7 MPa tsaka yung FI is 345 MPa. So yun, ito yung crucial part. I-analyze daw natin yung beam as doubly reinforced beam. So yun yung sabi niya. So since nung dati nag-analyze tayo as singly reinforced beam, ngayon i-analyze daw natin to as doubly reinforced beam. So yun yung gusto ng examiner eh, no? So i-analyze daw natin yung problem na to as doubly reinforced beam. So if ever hindi niya sinabi, di ba? Sabihin niya ano yung ultimate moment capacity nito. So yun yung time na kailangan mong i-check kung yung beam ba is under singly or doubly. Okay? Pero dito muna is doubly reinforced lang muna daw. Huh? Okay ba? So, analyze natin na doubly lang muna. Sige lang, later sa mag-provide din ako ng another video kung paano mag-determine kung doubly or singly reinforced. Okay? Sige. So, gawa tayo ng stress diagram. So bali ito yan. So if I assume ito yung compression block, yan. Okay, I assume ito yan. So dyan mag-act yung force na ng CC, no? So dito mag-act yung CC, which is ito yan. And then dito yung compression bar, di ba? So dito mag-act yung sa compression bar na that is CS. Okay? And then we have the tensile force that is dito, no? T. Okay? So yung CS natin that is equal to ES prime FS prime. Yung CC natin, this is equal to 0.85 FC prime EB, while yung tensile force natin is ES FS. Okay? So, kung kukunin natin yung mga moment arm nito, yung ito, so this is D minus A divided by 2, tsaka yung moment arm na to is also equal to D minus D, D prime. Okay? So, I hope klaro yan. So, yung first assumption na ginagawa natin is all steel yields. Ayan talaga yung first. Assumption. So, all steel yields. So, ibig sabihin, yung FS natin is equal FY, and yung FS prime natin equals FY. So, this is for tension bars. And this is for compression bars. Okay? So, by summation of forces along x-axis, so, meron tayong tensile force equals CC plus D CS. Diba? Kasi i-analyze natin as doubly. So, included yung compression bar. So, ngayon, meron tayong ES, FS, 0.85 ng FC prime AB, plus meron tayong ES prime, FS prime. Okay ba? So, ngayon, since yung assumption natin is all steel yield, so, meron tayong FS, then ito magiging FY, di ba? And we have 0.85 ng FC prime AB plus ES prime FY. Okay? So, continue tayo sa next page. So, substitute natin yung value. So, yung ES natin is meron tayong tatlong tag 28 mm bar. So, meron tayong tatlong tag 28 mm bar. Then, yung FY natin is meron tayong 345, no? So, 345. And then we have 0.85 nung FC prime natin, that is 20.7. Then ito yung gusto nating makuha, yung A. And then yung B natin is meron tayong 410. Yan yung effect, yan yung width ng beam. Then yung ES prime natin, meron tayong tatlong tag, 20 mm na diameter bar. And then yung FY natin is we have 345. Okay? So masolve na natin yung value ng A. So gamitin ko muna ng calculator. So therefore, so meron tayong tatlong tag shift pi over 4 na 28 squared. So yan yung steel area. Ano pa? Times yung FY na 345 na. Alpha equal. Di ba ito yan? And then 0.85. Okay. And then we have 0.85 ng FC prime, we have 20.7. Ang yung tanong is A, so alpha x ko na lang yan. And then yung B natin is 410, di ba? And then plus yung ES prime, that is tatlong tag, tinag 20 mm na. Tinag 20 mm. And then yung FY natin is 345. Shift solve. So we have A and that is 43.3. Okay. So this one is 43.3 mm. So yung C natin is makompute na natin yan. So therefore we have 43.3 and then we have 0.85 siya kasi ito less than 1 eh. Less than 28 megapascal, no? From 2010 or 2015. So therefore yung beta natin is 0.85. Okay? So we have 0.85. So therefore we have the value of C. And then that is just equal to, we have 43.3 alpha equal to 0.85 alpha x, shift solve for x, that is 50.9. Okay? 50.9. So, lagay natin yan dito. This is 50.9 mm. Okay ba? So, next is i-verify na natin if yung assumption is correct. Okay? Verify natin. So, compute natin yung FS which is 600 ng D minus C all over C. So, this is just equal to ilan daw? 600 yung effective depth natin is meron tayong 586. And then yung C natin is meron tayong 50.9 all over 50.9. So, therefore, this is equal to we have 600 times 586 minus 50.9 all over 50.9. So, therefore, that is equal to 6, yeah, sobrang laki, no? 6307.66. So ibig sabihin tension steel, so since this is greater than FY, so tension steel yields. Okay ba? So, pag mag-assume ka, kailangan mo i-verify yung assumption mo kung tama. So, continue tayo. So, next nating i-verify yung sa compression bar, no? So, yung FS prime. Yung FS prime is just equal to 600 ng C minus the D prime all over C. So, we have 600. Yung C natin is meron tayong 50.9. Sobrang liit. Minus 60 all over 50.9. So therefore this is 600 times 50.9 minus 60 all over 60. ay hindi, 50.9 all over C, 50.9, and then okay, this is equal to negative 107.3. So this is negative 107.3, so this is less than Fy, therefore compression still does not yield. So we use Fs, okay, we use Fs in the calculation. So since yung compression still does not yield, so we need to recompute for the value of C using yung Fs prime na 600 ng C minus the D prime all over C. So yan na yung magiging computation natin. Okay, so we need to recalculate for that. So balik tayo sa simula. Yung summation of forces along X, yung kita, summation of forces along X equal 0. So same lang. So kunin ko lang to, balik lang tayo sa simula. Ayan. So alam na natin na yung Fs talaga is mag-yield, no? So ibig sabihin dito is ESFY yung gagamitin ko, no? So we use Fs equals Fy, and then we have 0.85 yung Fc prime. Wait, Fc prime, then yung A dapat naka in terms of C na yan, kasi yung Fs natin naka in terms of C yan, no? Then times B plus yung ES prime natin. And then, yung gagamitin na natin ngayon is yung 600 ng C minus the D prime all over C. So, kailangan natin i-employ yung na-verify natin. So, ito na yung gagamitin natin sa pag-investigate. So, bali ngayon, ito nyo lang tayo. So, yun pa rin, no? Meron tayong tatlong tag, di ba? Tatlong tag 28 yun. Tatlong tag 28 at tatlong tag 20. So, pi over 4, 28 squared. Okay? Times yung Fy na 345. And then, we have 0.85 ng 20.7. And then 0.85 nung C, yung B natin is 410, di ba? Plus ES prime natin is tatlong tag 20mm na diameter bar, and then we have 600, and then we have C minus the 60 all over C. So makompute na natin yung value na C. So therefore we have computing ko muna. So meron tayong tatlong tag shift pi over 4 na 28 squared, times ko yan ng Fy ko na 345, alpha equal ng 0.85, yung Fc prime natin is 20.7, yung A natin ngayon magiging beta C, so 0.85 nung C, assume ko na yung X ko is C, 410 plus meron tayong tatlong tag pi over 4 na tag 20mm na diameter bar, no? So pi squared times yung Fs natin, which is 600 nung wait, okay, ah, wait, mali na pindot ko, ah. What? ulit. Namali yung napindot yung gasyong pi over 4, and then times 28 squared times 345, and then we have 0.85 ng Fc prime 20.7, and then we have 0.85 ng C, yeah, And then yung B natin is 410, na. Di ba madali lang isuulo yung formula? 3 times shift pi over 4 times 20 squared, yan yung sa compression bar, times yung 600. Okay, times yung ito, we have C minus D prime. So yan yung anon ko, C minus D prime, which is 60. And then all over C. Oops. Ship solve. Ayan, no? So neglected yung negative 68 na yan. So yung kukunin ko yung 80.5. So I have C that is 80.5 mm. So therefore, masolve na natin yung B, which is beta C. So we have 0.85 ng 80.5. So we have 0.85 times 80.5. So 68.425 mm. Okay, so try natin i-check ulit yung FS tsaka yung FS tsaka yung FY. So we have the FS, that is 600 ng C minus the D prime all over C. Yeah, check natin yan. 600 yung C natin is 80.5 minus 60 all over 80.5. Okay, so that is equal to, ilan yun yan? 6, wait. So we have 600 times 80.5 minus 60 all over 80.5. So therefore this is equal to, ayan, 152.8. This is less than FY, which is yun yung in-assume natin, ha? So okay na to, no? Compression does not yield. Okay na yan. So yung FS natin is meron tayong 600 nung D minus C all over C. So therefore this is 600 nung effective depth, we have 586, huh? Minus 80.5 all over 80.5. So therefore this is equal to, so we have 600 times 586 minus 80.5 all over 80.5, and that is just equal to, ayun. So okay pa rin, ha? So tama yung ginamit natin na FY tsaka FS. So this is equivalent to 3767.7. So this is greater than FY. So okay na, no? So ma-solve na natin yung value ng MN. So balik lang tayo dito sa force na to. So compute na natin yung MN. 'Di ba? Compute na natin yung MN dito. So ito na lang yung, dito na lang ako mag-moment considering yung CC tsaka CS ko. Kasi meron man din ako mga moment arm, 'di ba? So ma-solve na natin yung value ng MN. That is just equal to CC times D minus A divided by 2 plus yung CS natin, that is D minus the D prime. So therefore, yung MN natin is just equal to 0.85 ng FC prime EB D minus A divided by 2 plus yung CS natin, that is ES prime FS prime, na? D minus the D prime. So substitute natin yung value, we have 0.85 ng 20.7, yung A natin is, na-compute na natin yan, that is 68.425, no? So 68.425, and then yung B natin is given 410, yung effective depth natin is 586, di ba? Minus yung A natin na 68.425 all over 2. So okay na ako dyan. Then yung ES prime natin, meron tayong tatlong tag pi over 4 na 20 squared. And then yung FS natin is na-compute na natin yan. Na? That is 152.8. So yan yung gagamitin natin. So we have 152.8. And then yung D natin is that is 586. Yung D prime natin that is given 60. Diba? Yan dito. Yung ito. Okay? So, divide ko na lang ito lahat by 10 to the power of 6. So, makukuha ko yung value ng mn. Okay ba? So, okay. Compute natin yan sa calculator. So, therefore, we have this one. So, yung cc, we have 0.85 ng 20.7. Yung A natin is 68.425 times beam weight natin na 410 then 586 minus yung A natin na 68.425 tama ba? Divided by 2 and then plus yung sa CS na that is tatlong tag shift by over 4 na 20 bars okay times yung FS na diba? Yung FS natin is 152.8 so I'll be using 152.8 times 586 minus 60 okay equals so yung sagot na yan divide ko na lang ng 10 to the power of 6 automatic yung sagot in kilonewton meter so that is equal to 348.12 okay so this one is 348.12 kilonewton meter okay ba so yung m n yung phi mn natin is just since yung fs natin di ba dito sa ano natin kung ito yung phi natin ito yung fs natin so meron tayong compression control transition zone and tension control na so dito is meron tayong 100 then dito meron tayong fy so since yung fs natin is 3767 so isipin ko na lang nandito siya na ito yung 3767.7 so ibig sabihin it falls dito sa tension control, no? So, nag-fall siya dito sa tension control. So, yung phi is 0.9. So, we will be using 0.9 of 348.12. So, therefore, we have 0.9 times 348.12 313.3. Okay? 313.3 kilonewton meter. And yan na yung sagot. Provided na ito is i-analyze natin as doubly reinforced beam. Okay ba? So sa next na video, pakita ko kung paano mag-determine kung singly or doubly yung beam. Okay? Thank you.